Lansing, Michigan, Spartan Stadium and home of the Michigan State Spartans. This matchup today, part of the lifeblood of the sport, a rivalry game where the results will be remembered for a lifetime. As we'll see, the number 12 team in the country, the Indiana Hoosiers, taking on a fellow Big Ten foe, the Michigan State Spartans. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, joined here in the booth, as always, by David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Guys, let's tee this one up. And the Spartans will kick it away first. He'll bring it out. It's Williams. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. So the Indiana Hoosiers offense will get the first swing of the game. And the adrenaline is pumping on overdrive in games like this, guys, and it's crucial to get your emotions under control.
No doubt. In rivalry games, you've got to limit the mental errors, and you've got to limit the penalties, because those will kill you, Bob.
And you got to come out under control. It means so much. We know that. The fans are all talking about it, but it's just football.
This crowd, full throat, splitting the eardrums and letting them know it's going to be a long day. From the shotgun, they'll run it. Get him on the ground after a four-yard run out to the 31.
And, you know, when we talk about great third down defenses, it really starts with them getting stops on first and second down. You've got to get those stops early in the drives to set up third and long. So that's a missed opportunity on that second down by this defense.
Just need a few inches on this opening drive to pick up a first down. Still on his feet at the 45. And he's brought down after a nice gain.
It's a really good sign if you're on offense here. You're putting it on your offensive line on third down. Critical down and distance, opening drive of the game. Let those guys fire off, get a hat on a hat. You can run the ball, pick up the first. You're around midfield. And all things looking pretty good here early for this offense.
To throw, it's Rourke. A little screen to the running back. Not a whole lot of room there on that screen pass as it just never developed. You want to talk about building a drive around a guy, first on the ground and now using him in the passing game.
Man, you get so much bang for your buck because you can split him out wide. You can fake it to him and throw it. This is the guy that really stretches the field and makes you decide how you want to defend him. A linebacker, a safety, whatever it is, it's usually not good enough when he's receiving the ball out of the backfield.
Really nice run there. Good, solid pickup, and they'll move the sticks with a first down.
I think it's really important for this offense. They get this guy going early in the game, and they're doing a nice job of that right now. Remember, he's the kind of running back who gets better as the game goes on. That's a really good omen for this offense, considering his success now early.
Snagged in the middle, it's Price.
It's really easy to say the word RPO and say I'm going to run them, but you got to make those decisions, and you got to make them fast. You can't get confused by all the craziness that's going on, by all the guys moving around or talking. Nice job by the quarterback, staying in the moment, seeing it, throwing the slant, making sure he makes the right decision.
Trying play action. Fires deep toward the end zone. And they can't hook up, going for the big play on second down. Now it's third down. I know you want to prepare for every game the same way, but there's just something different about rivalry games, Jesse.
It's because, Reese, I think players are aware that games like this define your legacy as a player. Your record in rivalry games is something that people are going to talk about for years and years down the road. You have got to show up and play your best football in games like this.
Let me tell you, this senior quarterback can flat fit it in a tight window. They flexed out that tight end a little bit, and you know the tight end's always open.
Always open, quarterback's best friend, and this guy's a problem, Reese. He's a matchup problem because he's too big for DBs to cover, and he's too fast for linebackers to cover.
Fires and picked off. He was looking for room to return that, but he'll just hand it to the offense. They'll take over at the 18.
All right, I know it's early, but it's just one drive, right? You got to put this behind you. It isn't how you wanted to open up. It isn't how you wanted to start. This offense has got to go to the sidelines, get with the coach, settle down, and figure out the game plan for the rest of the game.
Offense set on first down. They'll run it out of the shotgun. He'll be stopped just short of the 20 at the 19. Give him one.
Now, that's what you're trying to do as a defense. Limit those damages when they run the football. Get them on the ground, short gains to set your defense for positive situations down the road.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and nine. Here's the handoff. Tried to move that pile forward. He maybe gets two. He's down at the 21. We had a barn burner the last time these two teams played, and no reason to expect anything else between these two bitter rivals.
Attention to detail, and I think the sense of urgency, David, in a game like this just goes way up.
And I think managing the emotions in these type of games, you know last year was a classic. Now you're trying to form this year's identity of this team and go out and get a win in a big-time rivalry game.
They pick up the first down on the drag route. I know that seems like a simple route, but it's actually a lot more complex than what it looks like, because that route changes based on whether it's man or zone. If it's man coverage, he's flying across the field. If it's zone, he's got to sit down over the ball in a soft spot, giving his quarterback a place to go with it. Nice job of those guys being on the same page there.
Pretty good job of running to get two there to the 32.
That's a really good job by the defense, wrapping them up, getting them on the ground. Take away that run game. Make them one-dimensional, put them in passing situations. Really good job by the defense.
After picking up a couple, it's second and eight. Back to throw, it's Childs. Makes the catch and steps out of bounds, but short of the first down mark.
Well, it's a nice job, too, of the quarterback after the play fake there, getting his eyes down the field. He had to get that to his tight end quickly, knowing he wasn't going to have a lot of space to run with after the catch.
Here comes a third down situation, and the defense hasn't been able to slow them down. They'll try to get the first through the air. Grabbed in the middle. It's Belling. And they'll move the chains and get it to the 47-yard line.
Well, it's a nice job by the tight end there. He's patient. He fights his way through all the traffic in the middle of the field, running that drag route, making it an easy completion for the quarterback.
The Spartans are moving quickly down the field. He wants to throw. Fires to the big fella. And good coverage by the defense, just a short gain.
A nice job by the defense there, tackling the catch and smothering the tight end. They know this offense is going to try to find him in the passing game in a lot of different situations. That time, perfect coverage, and nice job bringing the big guy down. Not easy to do.
A little bit more to go after that last completion. They'll try to pick it up on second down. And he was fortunate not to lose yardage on that play, able to wedge it back to the line of scrimmage.
Great job by the defense. Everybody firing off the ball, hitting their guys, holding their gaps, running to the football, nowhere to go.
If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. On third and long, he's going to have to throw for it. Shoots it to the left. He's got it. He's run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down. And it looks as if they've buzzed down. Replay wants to have another peek at that last play. And they take another look at the play, but the officials on the field were right, and the play will stand. Wide receiver shows motion. And he's brought down after a nice gain.
And there was no question in that scenario. That's where the quarterback was going. He knew he had his receiver in a matchup that he liked, running a route where he would find himself open. Nice job between those two.
Looking for a productive play on first down. We've reached the end of the first quarter, and it has been a defensive battle, and the stats tell the tale so far. Let's see if the offenses can find a little rhythm here in the second. And the Spartans have it with a first and 10. A running back has it. Snowed under after a pickup of 2. They'll mark it at the 8.
Man, a nice second effort by the back to break a tackle. But how about those defensive backs willing to come up, stick their face in the fan, and make a tackle?
Those are the best run defenses, too, right? It's not just D linemen and linebackers getting all the plays, but it's DBs that are willing to not just cover, but tackle backs in the open field.
They get him on the ground at the 3-yard line, but this defense is taking some punches.
I think you run that play on second down knowing it's going to make third down easy. You're not trying to hit a home run. You don't need the big play right now. Now you know third down, everything's on the table. Everything's available. High success rate.
Not a lot of ground to cover and not much to defend. A big third down. And he takes it to the house. Touchdown, Spartans. An impressive, long, methodical, meticulous drive ends in points.
They just matriculated the ball down the field, didn't they, Reese? So impressive. Didn't see a lot of explosive plays, but how about the execution? Running and throwing the football. Wow.
PAT unit on the field. And the PAT makes it 7-0. Precise, relentless execution on that 13-play scoring drive. And close the deal with a 3-yard touchdown run. The kickoff team on the field as they'll send this one away. On the move from inside his 5. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes and they'll stop him at the 16. Indiana has the ball back, and the Hoosier offense comes out ready to go. That last drive was promising for a while, but you just can't mess it up at the end with the pick, Jesse.
No, you've got to be able to finish drives, especially in this game, if you're going to win. And, David, they've got to be able to eliminate the mental mistakes.
Yeah, and I don't think you get conservative or play it safe. You can trust your guy. I think you put the ball right back in his hands and let him do his thing.
After the productive first down play, it's 2nd and 6. They'll try the run. Found a little bit of running room, knocked down at the 24 after a pickup of 4.
Just a simple power play. Again, not sexy. Run the ball up the middle. Physicality, offensive line gets to assert themselves, run block, which they love to do. This pays dividends down the road.
Boy, could they use a conversion on 3rd and short from their own 24. To the ground to try to move the chains. And he converts on 3rd down as he gets it out to the 26.
And I just love when guys know exactly where the sticks are. You could tell, ran with purpose, finished through the sticks, and got just enough for the first down.
And a nice job up front too, right? Good communication, everybody knew where they had to go, hat on a hat, work the double teams, and get some push.
Got him looking run, he wants to throw. Got it in the middle, it's Price. And the defense had that one well covered, just a short game there.
This is a very tough slot receiver to cover if you're a linebacker because of how quick and how shifty he is. You never seem to know which way he's going, and he always seems to create an open space for his QB.
Picked up some yardage with that completion, now 2nd down. They'll throw it to the back on the screen. They finally get him stopped, but what a good job by that front wall to set up the screen and create some lanes for their running back. That is a time-honored way to slow down the rush, hit him with the screen, and a chunk play.
Yeah, such a great job because you're flying up the field to get to the quarterback because everything looks like pass down the field. Let those guys get up the field, throw it right behind him. He does a little bit of the rest, making some moves, getting upfield, making the big play.
And here comes play number 6 of the drive. Looking downfield, it's Rourke. Throws to the tight end. A strike downfield. And they'll finally bring him down after he rips off a huge play. And he was able to break one tackle, Jesse, and almost got away from another.
Man, this secondary, this defense, they better pack a lunch. When this guy has the football, you've got to get bodies to him. And you better wrap up those legs and hold on tight. This dude's hard to tackle.
Leaves it with the back. Had to work to pick up three down to the 33-yard line.
I'll tell you, this is a running back who's very, very dangerous, and the defense did a good job getting him down there. But they got to do a great job gang tackling, because this is a guy that can break tackles and turn those types of plays into home runs.
Got three on first down at 2nd and 7. The give to the back. Trying to pound their way forward, he picks up a couple to the 31. Here comes this home crowd as the defense tries to get off the field on third down. Quickly complete. He will step out of bounds, but not before the big pickup and a first down for this offense.
Man, and we're seeing the tight end used more and more in the passing game. You see him moving inside. You see him moving outside. You see him moving in the box to block people. So here they put him in the slot and just have a nice little pitch and catch session.
From the red zone, he's going to throw it. Caught over the middle, it's Cooper. And that defense is all over that one. No room to run after the catch.
Well, the defense playing zone coverage there. They're taking away all of the QB's primary options down the field, so he has to check it down to the drag running underneath.
Still some work to do after that last completion at 2nd down. Back to pass, it's Rourke. He looks that one in nicely. He's really close to that first down marker, but they stop him just a bit short.
And quarterback dropping back, understanding, I'm getting zone coverage. All I got to do is be a little bit patient, manipulate that defense a little bit. My wide receiver runs that drag, and I get the first down.
It's 3rd down now, and they ought to be able to get off one more play before the 2-minute warning. They'll try to bully their way for the first. The Hoosiers will keep this drive going. We've reached the 2-minute warning, and we have ourselves a ball game, and they have a chance to take the lead here before the half. And now a chance to pull even, 1st and goal, as we get late in the first half. Use the play fake, now to throw. Into the end zone. They're intercepted. And the offense makes the tackle in frustration after the interception. Drive comes up empty, and it's a turnover.
This is obviously not a great start for this quarterback here. 2 interceptions already in this game. He's got to do a much better job with his decision making.
The Spartans have it back on offense, hoping to play some good ball. Jesse looking to take it down the field for back-to-back touchdowns.
I think it's really important for them moving forward, too, to have a lot of bounce, right? You want to be able to keep this defense guessing, Pollock.
Yeah, and you got me searching for answers after that last drive. You stack another drive on top of this, their defense's heads are going to be spinning all over the place.
After the 3-yard pickup, they come to the line 2nd and 7. He's got it again. Can't get him to the ground. A strong tackle and wrap up from the junior. Offense calls a timeout here. Critically important to make sure they have the right play call and everyone on the same page here. 3rd and short, they've got them back up inside the 20, and the D can get the ball back here. Back to throw, it's Childs. Quarterback moving. The Spartans get enough for the 1st down.
3rd and short is just tough, right? The whole playbook's open. You can run the football, you can throw the football, and then, by the way, you can also run the ball with the quarterback after you call the pass. So what do you want me to do? Here, you take the clipboard.
And the Spartans will have it 1st and 10. He's looking to throw it. And that incomplete pass caused by the big hit on 1st down. 2nd down coming.
The big tight end tries to make a catch, and you can tell he extends for the ball, but Great job by the defender getting in there, making the hit, dislodging the football out at the same time as he's going to catch it, and the big tight end couldn't hold on to it.
Right back to the air on second and 10. Unleashes it on the run. And they won't make the connection, looking to make a big play there.
Long incompletions are okay. We got to take shots. You got to make big plays in college football. I love that you're taking shots. Keep taking them. Some of those are going to come home. Some of them aren't. But when they come home, they equal big-time points.
This defense has kept them backed up. Now one more stop, and they can get off the field on third and long. And they're able to get a third down stop here. See if they go for it on fourth. There's a timeout on the field. Tight game here late in the first half. The Spartans line up to punt it away. The punter going to get his first work of the afternoon. Gives him a little shake, and he's... Where did he go? This guy is a daring punt return man. He's not going to settle for the fair catch. A solid return gets a little bit of ground for the offense. The official says no good. After that miss, still a 7-point game, guys. First half in the books. Time now to join Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Thanks so much, guys, and I need not tell you, rivalry games always bring out a ton of emotion, and no surprise, we saw just that in the first half today. And we can't get very far into this halftime breakdown without talking about that stud linebacker. The kid's been everywhere all at once through two quarters. From clogging gaps to causing turnovers, he's been a one-man gang, public enemy number one for that opposing sideline. With that, let's throw it back to the guys to see how this rivalry matchup plays out.
And the Hoosiers will try to kick this one deep to get things underway in the second half. The returner will field it and try to set up his offense in great field position. And they'll bring him down to get the offense started on the next drive. Good news, I guess, a lot of room to work with as they start this drive from their own 15. They keep it on the ground to open the third. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. Most offensive schemes are predicated on first down productivity. That will not go down as a productive first down play.
No, it will not, Reese. Give this defensive line credit because they were able to get penetration right off the snap and force a negative play.
One back in the backfield, and they'll give it to him. Works his way into the traffic and picks up 3 to the 17. A third and long coming up here. Looking to throw, it's Childs. They're bringing heat. And this is going to be incomplete on third down.
And finally, the defense is able to get some pressure on this quarterback. They had been trying all game long different ways to affect him. Weren't able to get there. But on that play, because of the pressure, it affected his accuracy. And that's why the ball falls incomplete.
And the Spartans will punt it away on fourth down. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. Might have thought he'd want to try to pick up a few yards there, but he's content with making the fair catch right around the 35-yard line. From the gun, he leaves it with the back. You'll take this every time, 5 yards on the first down play.
Really nice first down run, and you're seeing why this running back is an every down type. He can run between the tackles, he can run outside, he can catch the football, he can block. This guy can do it all.
Halfway there on first down, it's 2nd and 5. Pulls it and fires to the left. He's close to the first down, but they're going to mark him just a little short.
And offenses nowadays, they're really just counting numbers. How many guys do you have out wide? How many guys do I have out wide? If I have enough guys to block your guys, boom, it's just built into the offense. Pitch, catch, let me get a few yards.
Ball is at the 42-yard line, close to four down territory. Here's third and short. He's got first down yardage across the 50. They'll mark it at the 49.
Wow, the running back there showing you his skill set as he's able to rip off that one for a first down.
The Hoosiers will snap it on first and 10. From the gun, the running back has it. A solid pickup there before the defense is able to make the stop.
I like it. Just frustrate the defense. Get that 5 to 6 yards. Make them honor the run. Make them know that you're willing to run the football and run it effectively.
Halfway there on first down, it's second and 5. The give to the tailback. Able to pick his way forward for a decent game before the defense gets him down.
That didn't bust for a long one, but now third down becomes very manageable. It's not third in eternity. Now the whole playbook, short passing game, long passing game, all of it's available.
This feels like four down territory, third and short from the 40. They'll try to pick it up on the ground. They were all over him, nowhere to go as that third down play turned into a disaster.
Well, that play didn't stand a chance. I mean, nobody even blocked that guy. And he's able to get the tackle for loss.
They really have no choice here. This is a no-brainer. You go for it here on this fourth down. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. Complete, out of the backfield, looking for the sticks. There to make the stop, but they use the back in the passing game and pick up the first down.
And that's a play the defense has got to be able to make, guys, right there on fourth down. You're in the third quarter, second half, you're playing at home, and it's a close game. You've got a huge opportunity to seize momentum. And you just get the feeling that that momentum is going to be a big factor here in the second half. Someone had to step up and make a play, and they just couldn't get it done.
They stop him at the 22, 15-yard pickup on the play, and a first down just outside the red zone. Bunch formation for these receivers. It's a draw. They make the stop, but you can't give up 4 yards a chunk on the ground down in this area of the field. It's at the 18. The noise level is relentless here on second down. Give to the running back. He rolls all the way down to the 5-yard line before they finally get him stopped.
That has got to be demoralizing if you're on defense, because they just ran the ball right up the middle, down your throats, and they gashed you.
Fans are bringing the noise on first and goal. They'll try to get it in with the run. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Indiana.
And this running back is so dangerous down close to the end zone. He's got wiggle, he's got great vision and burst, and he showed all of those attributes right there.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. And the extra point was good. No incident there, and we are tied up in the third. They put together a 65-yard drive for the score, and they punctuated it with a 5-yard touchdown run. After that, latest answer tied things up, just about set to kick it away again. Here's the return from inside his 10. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Michigan State has the ball back, and here comes the offense. And in a low-scoring game like this one, David, every possession is magnified.
And I think more than anything, it just gets frustrating. And you got to put that behind you. You got to see what this defense has been doing to be so successful. Caller, now use it against them.
Yeah, David, I think for a play caller, this is tough, right? It's like you have to have the perfect play on just to get a first down. In these types of games, I think you're just trying to get guys out in space, see if a dude can break a tackle. Maybe that generates an explosive play, and it breaks this trend.
Showing off yards. And he's to the 48-yard line. That'll be good enough for a first down.
I love when players understand situations and they understand where the first down marker is and they understand where I got to get to. A lot of people you'll see run north-south and try to bounce out wide and make big plays. Sometimes it's not about making big plays. Sometimes it's about getting that first down to make sure I get an extra set of downs instead of trying to make those big touchdown runs.
Fires to the right. He makes a catch. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one and it'll be a first down.
That's a really good-looking throw, and I love the decision right there. When I think back to my favorite Michigan State quarterback ever, it's Kirk Cousins. Wasn't the biggest, wasn't the strongest, fastest, didn't have the best arm. But he made good decisions. He read the defense and threw the ball accurately on time. This guy has the ability to do that, too. And if he keeps this up, this offense is going to be tough to stop.
They'll try it over the left side. And he finds some solid space, makes a nice gain before the defense is able to stop him.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
This offense has a second down play. Gonna run it. It's Carter. They get him on the ground, and that'll be the final play of this third period. What a ride. It's been through the first three quarters of this game. We are all tied up. Let's check out some stats. These two teams about to find out what they're made of as we open the fourth, all tied up. Keeps it on the bootleg. Throws to the wideout. Can't hold on. He had him right down the middle, and he flat dropped it. Now on second down after the incompletion. Running back searching for a hole. They ripped off seven on that one. Now a third down and three.
And a nice job by the running back, finding space, getting downhill, making the good run. Great job finishing with his pads.
Boy, they love to move the sticks here and take a shot at it on first and goal. They're going to try to throw for it on third down. Catch in the middle. It's Glover. Good tackle there to stop him short of the first down. It'll bring up a big decision. They were really hopeful he could make a guy or two miss and pick up the first down, but he comes up a little short.
Yeah, and it's great defense. It's defense understanding where the sticks are, not missing tackles, getting the guy on the ground quickly. Really nice job by the defense understanding the situation.
Kick is good. The offense has 3 points to show for the drive.
All field goals are not created equal, guys. Kicks in the fourth quarter take the lead. They just seem to carry so much more weight. So give that young man credit for getting out there and knocking that thing through the uprights with all of the pressure, all the eyeballs on him. He delivered.
So after the made field goal, they'll kick it away and rely on their defense. Here he comes from inside his own five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. Indiana sends the offense onto the field. The sledding has been tough. Scores have been at a premium, Jesse, and every possession seems like it could switch the momentum of the game.
Yeah, Reese, for this offense, just feels like they just haven't been as physical. For this offensive coordinator, David, he's having to go deep into the playbook just to try to generate a first down.
Well, and the good thing is there's not a ton of game pressure because the other side's not scoring either. But if you can find that one thing that get that one positive play and then maybe you get those juices going, then something can start to build.
And he does a really nice job finding open space and making a good gain before the stop is made.
There's just so much for this defense to think about. They've had strong side runs thrown at them. Now the counter. They know that this offense can work into play action off of all these base runs, too. So much offensive volume this defense needs to worry about at this point in the game.
Nice job to get it past the sticks, and they get him down at the 35.
Well, they get another big run for a first down, and if you're on offense, you love the way your offensive line is blocking early in this game. They are getting tremendous movement, and they're making life pretty easy for these running backs right now.
And the Hoosiers have it with a first and 10. From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. At midfield, he's got room. They got him free for a big gainer down to the 43. What perfect execution on that big run. Everything perfectly blocked, and this guy doesn't need a lot of room.
I love how this offensive line communicates and works up front. You see guys winning their one-on-one battles. There's double teams happening. Guys are getting into the second level and creating big lanes for this running back.
Working the middle of the field, and it's complete. They get him down after he makes the catch.
This offense has their work cut out for them, man, because the coverage has been so tight. And if you're not throwing to the sideline or you're not getting past the sticks, this defense is going to tackle you inbounds like they just did on that last play and bleed the clock.
After that last completion, it's second down. The give out of the gun. Across the 25, he's got room. They finally make the stop, but the big run is plenty to move those sticks for the first down.
And that's all you want, right? You want that first down. Understand the situation. Understand I got to get north and south, get a first down, get a new set of downs.
They're in the red zone. First and 10 from the 20. To the ground. He's got it again. They pull him down at the 17 after a pickup of 3. Got 3 on first down at 2nd and 7. To the air, it's Rourke. Got his man quickly. He is stopped behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose yards on that one.
And I don't like the play call, guys. Screen pass at this point of the game against the defense, playing big zones, prevent, trying to keep the ball in front. It's just not going to work. You've got to take shots offensively.
Third down, and these fans trying to make it impossible to communicate. He'll keep it himself. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
One of the reasons I love this defense is because their DBs get involved, and they come screaming downfield. That's a pretty good athlete playing quarterback on that run, but because of the speed they have in their secondary, boy, they were able to get to him quickly.
And now on fourth down, they will put it on the shoulders of the kicker to save them with his foot. And this one splits the uprights. All tied up here in the fourth quarter. And we're all square as he's set to kick it away. On the run from inside his own 5. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. The Spartans have it back on offense, hoping to play some good ball. They go to the ground. He breaks a tackle. And not much doing there as that defense runs him out of bounds.
And the defense doing a great job committing to the run. When you commit to the run like this, obviously you can give up some plays in the passing game, but you got to stop the run first.
Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. Movement here from the tight end. Looking for a crease. It's Carter. Tackle is made at the 28 after a pickup of 3. They not only have to deal with this defense, but the noise from this crowd on third and four. Looking downfield, it's Childs. Makes the grab. A quick tackle made, but he's got plenty for the first down.
Well, there's a great example of the receiver working back to his quarterback on the curl route against man coverage. He drives back towards the football, makes the catch, and gets the first down.
The clock has stopped as we have reached the two-minute warning here in the ballgame. Now from the 40, it's first and 10. The Spartans come to the line with a fresh set of downs. They'll throw it on first down. And the pressure will get there. The sack. Down he goes in the waning moments. That could be a costly play.
What a nice answer by this defense. You give up the big play, you respond right back. You get the sack, create some momentum for your side. Nice job by this defense staying with it.
On second down, wants to throw. Buys a little time. At the 45 on his way. He gets the job done, picking up the first down, then getting down.
Every possession later in the game means so much more. You start getting the fourth quarter, one possession games, QB drops back and makes these first downs. These extra set of downs now become so much more important late in these ball games.
He'll come out throwing on first down. Fires to the wideout. And they can't make the connection.
Well, I know it hasn't been a tremendous day statistically for this quarterback, but his decision-making has been good enough to win this game. Hasn't thrown a lot of TDs so far, but when things aren't open, he throws it away like on that play right there. He's not putting his team in a bad spot, and that's why they still have a shot to walk out of here with a W.
Looking to pass. It's Childs. Unloads to the wideout. All kinds of room to throw that one in there. Timeout called by the defense. It's their first of the half as they'll go to the sideline and try to make adjustments.
If they're going to sit back in zone, I'm going to make sure I know exactly what they're doing, find those holes, find those crossing patterns, and take advantage of that zone coverage.
They pick up half of it. It'll be second and five. The defense going to stop the clock with a timeout. They want to make sure they have everybody on the same page.
I know the passing game sells and the passing game is exciting, but it's not exciting to get 5 or 6 yards a pop on the ground, but it will be very successful.
Might as well stick with him. Finally run out of bounds, but he has this offense rolling with a first down.
Defense is going to have their hands full trying to get this guy on the ground, man. He's got some serious moves once he has the ball in his hands.
What a finish we have unfolding here. The offense in the waning moments and a chance to take the lead. A first down run in the red zone. He steps and powers and works his way. They finally get him down at the 2. The defense burns their third and final timeout of the half. They moved it forward to the 2. Now it's second and goal. They're going to run it. Touchdown, Michigan State. And inside a minute to go, and they've got the lead.
And how about this offense, man? They knew they needed to execute. Great play calling, great drive, put it together. Now you got a chance to go up by 7 late in this ball game and then let your defense go on the field and seal it for you.
Ready to try the point after. The extra point is good, and now in the fourth, they're up by a touchdown and an extra point. Now that they have the lead, this kickoff unit has to stay in their lane, create some field position, and hand it over to the defense. He'll bring it out. It's Williams. And the return man has no place to run, no place to hide, and a place to be tackled. Indiana has the ball back, and the Hoosier offense comes out ready to go. How about that play to get a hand in there and force the incompletion?
Well, this defense has had the QB's number all game long. One of the reasons why is because this cornerback, when he's on an island, he's winning the 50-50 balls, and he's not letting anything get thrown over his head downfield. Great job in coverage, disguising what he's doing and knocking balls away.
After the incompletion, they go back up top. And he can't find anyone open, and down he goes. A sack here late in the fourth.
You know, for this quarterback late in the game, you just need to have a better concept of the situation. Can't take sacks at this juncture. I know that the play gets thrown off, the timing's off, and you're forced to roll out, but if nobody's open, either run the ball, get what you can, get out of bounds, or throw that thing away. Can't take negative plays at this point.
Trailing by a touchdown, this fourth down opportunity is gargantuan. Desperate to convert, and he'll throw it. Can't find his man. It'll be incomplete, and that is a heartbreaker this late in the game. Looks like the offense will just take a knee.